What is going on? Back again. It is your boy Sniper Jones Jones, and welcome back to another video. Fuck yeah, head top. Today we have a very special video. This is my first time ever doing an Air Jordan 1 sneaker collection, and it actually surprised me on how many Jordan 1s I have, because I didn't know I even had that many. Now, I have done sneaker collection videos in the past. I did like a Yeezy video before, and then I did like an entire sneaker collection video before, and today I'm here to give you another. Now, I did ask a lot of you guys what was y'all looking forward to, and y'all told me the Air Jordan 1 video, so thank y'all for the people who tuned in and told me, hey, look, this is what we want to see. So guys, if you're new to the channel, make sure you go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Number two, make sure you hit the notification bell so you know when I'm dropping these bangers. Check out Rejuvenator, guys. Rejuvenator is the best cleaning product out there on the market. It is what I use on a day-to-day. It's no way possible I can show y'all all these Jordan 1s and not tell y'all what I use to clean my Jordan 1s and every other sneaker in my collection. I use Rejuvenator. In my hand right now is the signature cleaning kit. You can find it over at Rejuvenator, and it comes with pretty much everything you need for a great cleaning. Now, not only does Rejuvenator have stuff to keep your shoes clean, but they also have a lot of stuff that can prevent your shoes from being dirty. So if you guys are looking for a good sneaker cleaner and you need to clean your shoes, I suggest that you head over to Rejuvenator. There's a link down below. Head over there, screenshot me your purchase, and I will shout you out on Instagram, Twitter, whatever, when you send it to me, and hey, I appreciate it. But let's get to the video. All right, man, coming in as the first one we're gonna talk about, this is the Air Jordan 1 Shattered Backboard 3.0. I wanna be honest when it comes to this one, it's really not one of my favorites. I didn't really like the wax over type look, and I didn't really like the aged orangish bottom. But I gotta be completely true, this is the only Shattered Backboard I own. I love the original Shattered Backboard. I love the Shattered Backboard 2. I don't have either one, so the 3.0 is what I had to rock with. I mean, orange is my favorite color. I mean, a lot of you guys know that. So it's not ugly. I don't think it's ugly. I just don't think that it's better than the other two. And I'm actually even looking forward to the new Shattered Backboard. It's supposed to be dropping either this year or next year, because that one looks fire. I'm not gonna lie. But we have the Shattered Backboard 3.0s. Let me know what you think about these down below. Next is the Air Jordan 1 that I actually wear pretty often. For some reason, I don't wear my ones as much as I should. It's a few pair I really wear, but a few I really don't. I wore these to Cleveland a few times. I think I wore these to Cleveland twice. Ironically, both times I wore these shoes, I was out. I was traveling, and I wore them to Cleveland. That is the Air Jordan Court Purple. I love this Court Purple. I believe this one is the Court Purple 2.0. And yeah, it's fire, bro. As you can see, white, purple, can't beat it. You know what I'm saying? Easy colorway, smooth. The material is pretty good. So yes, the Air Jordan 1 Court Purple 2.0. The next Jordan 1 in my collection is something that I try to finesse a little bit, okay? We got the, what was this? Like the Paris to New York, or New York to Paris, or something like that. It came exactly with the LA to Chicago Air Jordan 1s with the rub off paint. I still can't believe the video I did for this is like at 100K or like 80K. It's something crazy. And I am not no sneaker, what do you want to call it? Like a sneaker artist. Or I do not design shoes, like none of that, bro. I don't do any of that stuff. And I just try to be creative as I possibly can and do something with these. I don't know if y'all like them. I know I messed up a lot, but that video did great. And a lot of y'all gave me a lot of feedback on that. And when I wear them, a lot of people ask me where I got them from. And I tell them, like, it's to rub off paint. And I did terrible, if you ask me. But it is what it is. I do get my wears out of these, to be honest. But, you know, I just wish I was a little nicer with the customization. I think I could have did a better job. But we have the, what is this, the New York to Paris or something like that. I can't even remember the name. I'm sorry, bro. Next up, we have the Royal Toe Air Jordan 1s. These are fire. Yeah, the Royal Toes are definitely hard. I don't think I wore these, though. I wore these, like, on the On Foot video, as y'all can see. I did like a review on foot. I did throw them on feet, but I've never like worn them with a fit. I don't have no reason why. These are like my poor man frags. I don't own a pair of frags because they cost too damn much. But these are my poor man frags, and I appreciate them. Okay, just because I don't wear them don't mean I don't appreciate them. They will be worn for sure. But yeah, these are smooth. I love the black, white, and blue color blocking. I think it's fire. Like I said, I don't think I'm ever gonna own a pair of frags unless I'm just like, you know what I'm saying? Unless y'all get me to 100K by the end of this month, you know, so then I'll buy a pair of frags, you feel me? But until then, I'm not gonna go out and buy a pair, bro. So I'm just cool with this. It's like the same color block, and of course it's way less hype, but I still think it's a solid Air Jordan 1 in my opinion, and I'm happy to have the Royal Toe in the collection. So we did the Royal Toe, and in my opinion, if you do the Royal Toe, it's only right you do the Bread Toe, okay? So we got the Bread Toe Air Jordan 1. Might be I own God, bro. This might be my favorite Air Jordan 1 in my collection, bro. The color blocking of this red, black, white, it's the obvious Chicago, but I love the bread toe. I don't own the breads. You know, that's one that hurts me to this day. I had a chance to get a pair of breads, and I just, bro, I dropped the ball. If y'all want to hear that story, I'll drop a story time on that. It's funny as hell, bro, but I do not own a pair of the breads. And to this day, I want a pair. I don't own a pair. But the bread toes just, I mean, they do me right. You know, I love this shoe. The material of this shoe, I remember when it first dropped, people were going so crazy for this material. They thought it was going to be way less limited than it was. Wound up being super limited. And I believe the catch was like, it was available in like a bunch of stores, but stores only had like limited amount of pairs. So yes, bread toes. Love them. Happy I got them. And probably one of my favorite Air Jordan 1s in the entire collection. Another one of my favorites is the Air Jordan 1 Turbo Green. This Turbo Green colorway is just so fire. It's like this weirdest turquoise blue. I mean, and then it got like the purple Nike swoosh with the yellow on the Nike Air. I mean, bro, this is just fire. I'm not gonna cap, man. Has to be one of my, it's another one of my favorites. Another thing I liked was I don't own any off-white Air Jordan 1s, right? And we all know the off-white Jordan 1s kind of have the deconstructed tongue. So this one has the deconstructed tongue as well. You see that? Just like the off-white UNCs or like the off-white Chicagos, they got that destructive tongue. Same way here. They even got like the small print on the side. You feel me? Jordan 1 High OG. Definitely a banger. I love these, man. Let me know how y'all feel about these because I thought they was fire. I still think they fire. And the material busting. Look at that tumbled leather on the side of these joints, bro. You see that? You see that tumbled leather? Great shoe to have, bro. Great shoe. Next up, we got the big boy court purples, okay? So first we had the court purple 2.0, and now we got the big boy court purple. This one has the black color blocking. As you see, the other one had just the white and purple color blocking. And like I say, I still like the other one better. The material is so much better on this pair than the 2.0. I like the 2.0 color blocking better, but when it comes to like material, and when it comes to like the actual quality of the shoe, this one takes the cake for me. Now, I don't even like purple like that. So it's weird that I got the first one in the 2.0, but I'm happy I got both because now I don't have to beat the hell out of one just to rock, you know what I'm saying? Like just to rock one because you can pull off the same fit with either shoe because the color blocking is so close, it really don't matter. But that just, you know what I'm saying? Save me some bread because I ain't got to buy another pair. So we got the Air Jordan 1 Court Purple. It's another banger if you ask me. Okay, so we got some Air Jordan 1s, okay? We did some Air Jordan 1s and it was cool, you know what I'm saying? It was all right, but I know a lot of my hypebeasts out there really want something a little bit more. So I got you, bro. The Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott Steel DS, never worn. I know I laced them up, but I still never worn these, bro. Never even tried them on. And I know so many people rock these as like, you know, what do you want to call it? So many people rock these and they beat them up, you know, and it's cool, man. I'm not one of them dudes that don't wear their shoes. It's just like, damn, I was this close to wearing these on my birthday. My birthday was September 2nd. That is the reason why they laced up. They weren't even laced until my birthday came. And I could throw them on with this, you know what I'm saying? Like, I could throw them on with this, to be honest. But I laced these up on my birthday. I was about to put them on, and I just changed my mind. I bought another pair of sneakers to take the edge off wearing these, and I'm gonna show y'all a little bit later. But yeah, we got the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott 1s, bro. I got these for retail. I got them for retail. I hit these on Nike sneakers, bro. Like, that was one of the best days of my damn life. Hitting this for a pair, I think these go for like 1,700, maybe even more. I don't know, bro. I haven't checked, but I hit these for retail. It don't get no better than that, bro. It don't. Travis Scott 1. Next up, we got the Air Jordan 1 Game Royal, and I probably wore these Jordan 1s more than any other Jordan 1s in my collection. When they first came out, I think I wore them like every day for like 2 weeks, which is a lot, because when you have a lot of sneakers like this, and I even got more off camera, it's not that you don't want to wear your shoes, but it's like you have so many, it's a rotation, bro, you know, and sometimes stuff just get forgot about or just haven't get worn because you got other stuff with the same colorway, so yeah, whatever. Anyway, the Game Royal is probably one of my most worn sneakers. I like it. Very cool, very simple. The material is not the best on these, but still, a great colorway and a great shoe to have in the collection. Air Jordan 1 Game Royal. Now, this one is a fan favorite, I'm not gonna lie. I definitely wore the hell out of these too, and that is the Air Jordan 1 UNCs. This is the, not the off-white that everybody go crazy for. I just love the UNC period. Now, you can even tell by the toe box how much I wore these, bro. Well, actually by this one, yeah, there we go. Yeah, show them creases. Show them creases. The material on these are fire. And I had these before the Off-Whites even came out. So I've been a fan of the UNC colorway. I've been a fan of the UNC Jordan 1. I do not own the UNC Off-White Jordan 1. I would really like to have that. So if anybody out there has a pair in a size 12, even 11 and a half, and can work with me on a price, okay? Just work with me. DM me, my Instagram and my Twitter is down below. I will talk to you, bro. It just has to be a reasonable price. Just work with me, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna work with you. But we have the Air Jordan 1 UNC. I might wear these today. I'm not gonna cap. I love these things. They feel so great. And I'm telling y'all, I had them for this long. The material, you know what I'm saying? The shoes is this clean. Get your Rejuvenator, man. Get your Rejuvenator. Next up, we got a pair of the Air Jordan 1 Shadows. Bro, I have never worn these shoes outside of the unboxing video I did for you guys when I did the on foot. And that's my fault. Because as I'm looking at this, man, this is a beautiful shoe. I mean, this really is a beautiful shoe. I like the black and gray. I like the white midsole. It can go with so much. And as I'm holding these in my hand, I'm thinking about every outfit in my closet right now that will go perfectly with these. And I have no excuse. I have no excuse to why I wasn't wearing these, bro. I really don't. I was surprised when these sold out, kinda, because I remember when they first dropped, nobody cared about them. But it's a different time, right? Different era. We all know that Air Jordan 1 kinda dominates the resale market, and Air Jordan 1 kinda dominates retail markets as well, because when you can get them for retail, it's always a profit margin to make. So, I mean, the Shadows are always gonna be a great cop. And honestly, I need to get my words out of these too, y'all. I'm just confessing to y'all today, but y'all my therapy. Air Jordan 1 Shadows. Wake up the sleepers, all right? Now the sleepers are about the way, let's talk about it. We got the Air Jordan 1 Blue to Great Mid. Let me put that back, Blue to Great Mid. I know y'all hate Jordan 1 Mids, bro, I know it. But some mids are just too hard to miss out on, right? So this came out of that Fear Pack. The Fear Pack was crazy, had some crazy ass heat in the Fear Pack. And this was a pair that I could not pass on. I hit these on sneakers, but even if I didn't hit them on sneakers, I would have paid whatever I had to pay, because I remember I was on my way to Florida when I got these, and I hit for them right before I got on my plane. These are crazy, bro, look at this. Rather be the material, the color blocking, you know what I'm saying? It's a mid, and I get the mid cut might not be the coolest, but like I say, it's still just certain colorways that just cannot be passed on. Like that women's pair of mids that's coming out. It's like white, blue, it got the stitching on it. I cannot remember the name, I'm sorry, but that pair is fire. I like the bread mid, those are fire. It's a lot of mids out there that's kind of tough. I'm not gonna hold you, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I think sometimes we need to stop sleeping on the mids, bro, because these are hard. Air Jordan 1 mid, blue to gray. Now, the final Air Jordan I will be showing y'all in my collection video, another hype one. And the reason why I don't plan on wearing my Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott highs that much is because I went and picked up the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott lows. I love the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott lows. And I know I sound like a hype beast, bro, because I don't own any other lows, but it is what it is, right? Hype has to do something with picking up shoes. It just is what it is, bro. But I like this shoe. I also like the Court Purple lows too. I'm just not buying no damn Court Purple lows when I got the other two. I don't like Court Purple that much, but if I didn't have both of the two, I would have the Court Purple lows. I really like those. The Air Jordan 1 Low Travis Scott is a shooter that I picked up when I was out there in Tampa. Shout out to Vault 813. They gave me a good deal on this. I still had to pay a pretty penny, I'm not gonna lie. This is probably the most I've ever paid for a Jordan. Actually, yeah, it is. It might be the most I ever paid for a shoe, bro. It was a lot. Yeah, I ain't okay. It was a lot, but still though, these are hard, and I really wanted to wear these like 2 days ago, so I started to unlace them. I was gonna put in the pink laces, but I changed my mind. I don't know, but I will wear these though. Before I wear the highs, I'm gonna beat these up, and that was my whole point of buying these, was to take the pressure off wearing the highs, and I can just rock out with the lows, because I can wear the same exact thing I wanna wear with both colorways. But to end the video off, we got the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott lows. Happy to have them. These are crazy. Well, hopefully you guys enjoyed that video, man. If you want to see more collection videos of any other sneaker, then let me know down below in the comments, or just hit me up on Instagram and Twitter. I appreciate y'all for watching as always. But before you leave, rate my Jordan 1 collection. I know compared to other YouTubers, bro, I got a long way to go. But to be honest, I'm not in no competition, man. I just love sneakers, and I love the ones that I own. There's other ones that came out I could have picked up, but realistically, I just didn't want them, or I just didn't have the luck on getting them. Regardless, let me know how you feel about my sneaker collection of my Air Jordan 1s, and I will be in the comments replying and just seeing what y'all got to say. Until next time, it is your boy, Sniper Jones. Do not forget, we on that road to 100K. New message. I am dropping new merch at 70K. So if we can get to 70K, new merch is on the way. It's already sketched up and designed. I'm just waiting for 70K. So, hey, let's do it. Until next time, it is your boy, Sniper Jones. You know I cannot leave without saying everybody want to be famous, but who really putting in that work, though? Snipe Squad, I love y'all. Dream big.